Alright guys, let's get started. We're going to start by drawing the pattern on the construction plane flat, and we're not going to be bothered with the exact shape yet, just to generate the pattern. And for that, we would need an extra plugin for Grasshopper, and that plugin is called Lunchbox. So first, let's fire up Grasshopper by typing in Grasshopper in the command prompt. And as you can see, I already have installed the Lunchbox plugin. If you haven't done that yet, you can go to the website called foodforrhino.com and simply download the plugin from there. If you have downloaded the plugin, you can go to File, Special Folders and Component Folder. And you can simply paste the file you downloaded from the website to this directory. This is the file name. So if you have done that, you can simply go back to Rhino and type in unload Grasshopper. Grasshopper unload plugin. And Grasshopper will actually unload. And then if you type in Grasshopper again, it will load again with the plugin you just installed, which is the Lunchbox plugin. And if everything worked out, an extra tab will appear. And this is the one we're concerned with right now. The one we're actually interested in is called Hexagonal Panels on Surface. So first, let's insert a surface component. So simply double-click the canvas and type in surface. And our next component is going to be the one from Lunchbox. So simply go to your Lunchbox toolbar, which for me is located here, and click on the Hexagonal Cells component and connect the surface to the surface. And before I forget, let's draw a surface in Rhino on the top view. This can be a simple surface because we're not worried about getting the exact shape right. We'll do that later on. So something more or less like this. Don't worry about the size. You can adjust that later on. So simply select the surface and link it into surface component. So now let's insert two sliders so we can adjust the U and V spacing and the number of cells. So simply double click the canvas and type in slider. Now double click the slider and let's switch the rounding to n, to integer numbers. And let's make this one to the maximum number to 50, more or less. Select the U divisions and simply Ctrl-C, Ctrl-V to copy the slider. Let's set the U more or less to, let's use 20. And for the V, let's use 10. Nice. So what we want to do is to actually separate the inside hexagons from the ones that are close to the edge, because those are half, and we're not going to be using that. So we're going to use a trick, and which we're going to count the corners from the hexagons to separate the ones on the border and the ones on the inside. So there's a component called discontinuity. So if you double click on the canvas and type in more or less discontinuity, the word, it will appear. This basically tells you, if you insert a curve, how many discontinuities there are. So of course, for a hexagon, it should be 6. And the ones on the border, they're going to have 4. So here you can see that. So now simply we need to measure the length of the amount of points to separate them. So simply now type in list length on the canvas. And let's insert a component called smaller than. And a fast way to insert an integer slider is simply to type in a number, and a slider will automatically be created, which is really nice. So simply type in 4 and hit enter. And now you can see an integer slider got created. So let's set this slider to 6. And now the only thing we're missing is a dispatch component. And we're going to link the cells to the L. And don't forget to graph this input. And the output of the smaller than component goes in the P into the pattern. So let's connect a curve component to the B. Switch this one off. And let's also hide the surface for now. Simply select the surface in Rhino and type in hide. As you can see now, the hexagons got separated from the ones that are on the inside with the ones that are on the outside. So these are the ones we're concerned with. And to make it a little bit more easy, we're going to only work with 4 hexagons, like in a group together, and not with the whole pattern. So it's a little bit more easy to see what we're going to do. So let's see the numbers of the hexagons. I have a trick for that. So we can use, let's first insert a component called point list. And let's connect that component to the centers from the hexagonal, from the lunchbox hexagonal component. And here you can see like all the hexagons that are there. So what we want is like a group of 4 hexagons, which is this group here. So the numbers 7, 12, 13, and 18. So let's select those from the output from our dispatch component. So let's first insert a tree branch component. What this component does is basically you can select branches of a tree. And that's what we want. So let's simplify this output. So it just gives us the numbers of the branches. Let's insert a panel. And let's type in the hexagons we want to use, which is going to be, 7, 12, 13, and 18. Sorry, I did it a little fast for the people that didn't see. If you insert a panel, it's automatically, multi-line data is automatically switched off, which means that now these 4 numbers are in the same list, let's say, but we want them to be having their own indices. So simply right-click and switch off multi-line data. So now they have their own line, let's say. Connect this one to the P and from the dispatch to the T. And now if you can see like our 4 hexagons got selected, so that's nice. Let's delete this one. And let's flatten the output from this component. So what we're going to do now is to switch the point list off because we won't be needing it right now. We're going to explode these lines. So simply double click the canvas and type in explode. And with our exploded line segments, what we're going to do is to get the midpoint of these exploded line segments. There's a component called point on curve. So simply double click the canvas. This one, point on curve. So connect that one to the line segments. And as you can see, the hexagon's now got an extra point in the middle in the line segments. Now the next thing we want to do is to evaluate the same curve. So simply type in evaluate curve. And connect the line segment again to the curve. Don't forget to reparameterize. And let's insert a slider. This one, just a simple slider from 0 to 1. And connect them onto the T. So now we have a slider where we can control the... This is going to be the slider where we can control the rotation. It's going to be our most important slider. And this is going to be controlling the rotation of the pattern. We will see in a second. So let's put it to 0.75 for now. So what we're going to do is we're going to connect these two points, like the midpoint, which is always going to be the same, and our point we can actually control. So we need to shift them. We need to do some list organization, so we can actually connect them with a line segment. So one list, we need to shift them up. So let's insert a shift component. Simply double click the canvas and type in shift. Shift list, that's the one we want. So let's connect the point on curve one to that one. And let's simply, don't forget to set the rep values to true. It's automatically set to true because this time we actually want that to happen. Simply copy it and connect the evaluate curve also to the slider. So now simply insert a slider with, simply type in 0 because we want a slider with 0. And let's double click the slider and set the minimum to -1 and the maximum to 1. So we can use it later on. So let's connect the 0 to the S. This is how many spots you want to shift it. Because this one we want to keep it at the same spot. Let's copy it. And let's set this one to 1. And let's connect that one to the other one. So now if you insert a line component, simply double click the canvas again and type in line. Oops, as you can see that, let's switch everything off to see what happened. As you can see, we switched it to the wrong direction, because look, if I do 0, so which basically means that both lines, they didn't got shifted at all. So now it basically just draws a line from the midpoint to the point we can control. But we want it to actually go to the next one, so we need to shift one list. So we can actually shift the midpoint one like this, because this is what we want in the end. Because if I zoom out a little, you see we're almost there. Like we almost already generated the pattern we wanted to have. Because look, if I switch this slider to 0.5, you can see that like the pattern already got generated. But I wanted to actually give you a definition that actually works with, because 0.5 is a special case. But if you, for instance, if you switch it to 0.75, like we said in the beginning, you see that some lines are not continued. And I want to actually finish the definition in a way that the hexagons are always like, are forming a closed loop. So there's no segments that are half, let's say. So next section, we're going to finish this definition.